So I picked up another rifle here. Two of the rifles that I like the best are Mausers and Mannlicher Schoeners. This here is a Mannlicher Schoeners, and it is a 1950 model, which we'll get into some of the specifics after we take it out to the range to shoot it. But got this guy. It is a rifle version, not the carbine, so it has the long barrel, 24-inch barrel. And as far as I can tell, it is unmessed up. In other words, it still has all the original stuff on here. It also has a rare factory mounted scope on here. So let's go to the range and we'll come back and take a closer look at the rifle itself. All right, got my new Mannlicher Schoeners 1950 out at the range today. Winchester Super X 150, 150 grain. Just gonna shoot some rounds off here. So far I've been about 2-inch groups. So the last 5 out of this box, and then we'll take it home and talk about it. Thing looks pretty good about it so far.
You're really close, but yes, sir. Sure will.
Well, that one was right at 1-inch. Alrighty, it's getting better. So let's take a closer look at our Mannlicher Schoeners that I just got. This is a 1950 model rifle. And like I said before, it has, and I got you zoomed in here a little bit so you can see the rifle better, but it has a 24-inch barrel. And this is all factory stock, it looks like. It has the double set triggers here. And let's show you. It is open, so you have 2 set triggers here. You have the back one that sets it and the front one that fires it, and it's a very nice light trigger pull. And you also can use just the front trigger as well. You can see here, you just pull back a little bit harder, get all the way to the back, and it actually pushes up and releases it. That's not really a too smooth of a trigger pull, and it's a lot heavier than the set trigger. So I will be using the set trigger. Going over some of the other features here, the set triggers actually can be adjusted right here. Now I haven't messed with it yet, but I probably will. There's a set screw here that'll make it either lighter or heavier. There's actually 2 safeties on this rifle. There's one here, which is on the side. That does not lock the bolt and travel. But they put that on there so you can put a scope on. And there's also a wing safety here, which we'll look at after we pull the scope off. Which, by the way, has factory-mounted scope rings on it. And if you can see here, it mounts in front of the receiver on the barrel in the front, and then also on the back here. Now let's flip it around. You can see it a little better here. Hopefully I get this centered in the camera, closer to it anyways. So, this here, guy, you just push this in and then swivel it to the side. Now let's see if I can get it turned around this way, which of course I can't. Let's do it this side. So, on the back, that little button that I just showed you, you push in, and the whole assembly swings to the side. I'll turn it that way so you can see it a little bit better. And then goes 90 degrees, and you can pull it straight off. And you can see here's the mechanism right here. This little post here goes in first, and then you swing it 90 degrees. This portion here actually slides into the back here. Now, I have another rifle that has a slightly different factory scope mount on it, but I have tested it over and over again, and it does actually hold 0, sort of surprisingly enough, because you would wonder about that, you know, going back to where it should be. But it's very solid whenever it's in there. Now, let's take take this off here, and we'll have a little look at the action itself. See, the Europeans like being able to take their scope off and putting it in a case so that it's safe from being bumped. And then also, I think that they often use the open sights more than what we do. You can see here, this guy even has a two-leaf sight here. I believe it's a 100 and 200 yard sight there that you can, let me move it back in here, that you can flip back and forth and use for different ranges. So this was actually at the time whenever scopes weren't as reliable as they are today. So it was more common for them to want to have backup sights. And the safeties, like I was talking about here, you can see here's the wing safety. This one actually locks the entire bolt mechanism itself, so you can't open it, which I kind of like, but of course you can't use that with a scope. So you use this one over here, safe and fire. Now in the 1950 model, you actually have a stripper clip bridge here. So you can actually take five rounds on a stripper clip and zip them right in there in the 270. So I'll give you a little look there at the crest of the rifle. I like these rifles because they're just very, just a classic 1940s, 30s, 50s kind of thing. Now the bolt release is on the side over here, and the bolt is very different from, say, like a Mauser bolt. You can see there's a lot of extra stuff going on there. Of course, the bolt handle is further up, and it's in front of the back of the receiver there, so that actually acts as another sort of like a safety lug in the Mausers would. The extractor is really cool. It actually has a, it's like a sliding extractor on the side here, and there's a projection actually on the bolt that'll bump that, and it ends up actually kicking the shell out. Shell goes underneath the casing goes underneath the extractor there, and then I guess that would be more considered the ejector. And you can see there it would go past the face of the bolt and boot the cartridge out. Another really cool feature of the Mannlicher Schoeners is actually the magazine itself. It's a rotary magazine, and it also has a feature on here to unload the magazine, because you can't unload it from the bottom. That's fixed in place. I'll show you that in a minute. So used up all my shells, so just throw a couple empties in here. See, very smooth actually in getting these guys in. Oops. Positioned right. Without the bullets in them, they are further forward than what they should be, after I tell you that it's very smooth getting in. Anyways, very smooth getting in, so even with empty cases there, basically, you know, you come down this way, and this will spool out all the empties. And, of course, if I wasn't trying to get on video, I hopefully would have caught some of those. But very cool feature there, very reliable and extremely smooth, because once it has the pressure off of that, and the only thing that's holding is right here, they're very smooth feeding rifle. Let me show you the bottom of the magazine here. If you need to get in and actually work on the magazine, all you have to do is push in this little button here with something that's not going to mar the finish. Like so, and just turn it to the side. It slides out. There's nice little machine recesses there. Goes in, and you can pop out your magazine. And you can see here, that's actually the surfaces where each one of the cartridges sits. And that's why whenever I had it a little bit further forward, you can see it's machined in right for the shoulder of the cartridge. So the cartridges aren't going to slip around the magazine. And like some of them, whenever they feed, you can bash the nose of the bullets up against the edge. Mannlicher Schoener eliminates that, because it basically is specifically made to have the cartridge sit right there, and it won't go any further forward on that shoulder. And very easy to put back in again. And I'm just going to make sure she's lined up properly. Oops. If I do it the right way around, and there, all done. Now I took it to the range, and, one other thing here. Can I have a look at the stock? This is a typical European stock. It is pretty thin, and it also has a cheek piece on it here, and then it has a plastic buttstock on it. All the way on the other end, it has a iron sight, very nice one, and it has the factory hood on it, which I like. And I think this isn't horn, I think this might be plastic in the front. And you can see here there's actually a barrel band as well, which contrary to what everybody does today, they didn't free float the barrels, they actually cinched it down and made sure it was tight for accuracy. Speaking of accuracy, I did take it to the range, and I only had one box of shells for a 270. I don't have any other 270s. I got some Winchesters here. Let's see, 150 green power points. So took them out, and I was a little limited on the amount of shooting I could do. Most of my groups were kind of scattered a little bit, but you can see I get a group right there. And this actually was my last five shots. I did pull this one that I knew Last four shots that I did that. So take that for what it's worth. Like I said, I only had one box of shells. So what I need to do is do some hand loading and get back out again and see what the actual potential for accuracy is for this rifle. So that is the Mannlicher Schoner 1950. And I do love this scope mount here. I'll have to see if I can figure out a way of getting a more modern scope on it, because I like to have something that's a little bit better for the weather. But this is a factory original Mannlicher Schoner, unmolested, and now a new one in my collection. All right, if you like my videos, please subscribe, and out.